So, this is just going to be a voiceover from Destiny on the state of Crucible and my kind of thoughts and feelings on how Crucible is, what I think should change, and just overall going with how Crucible just feels too repetitive and stagnant as it stands right now. So maybe there's something that Bungie can do to fix this issue, but for the most part, I have a feeling a lot of this is going to be fixed with Destiny 2, or at least I'm hoping, and looking forward to covering Destiny 2 once news starts breaking. But so for now, I go in, I do some of the things, I'll be recording gameplays, so for when I do make videos, I will have Destiny gameplays. And let's jump into it. Crucible. Behind me is the Iron Banner from that just happened last week from November, the first week of November. Second week, whatever it was. Yeah, it was the second week of November. There was the Iron Banner, and loot, I feel, still doesn't drop as well as it feels like it should. It's still too much of a grind for loot. Especially if you're looking for something particular, the chances and likelihood of getting it are just too low. So, right now, which pretty much is why I haven't really been doing a lot of covering of Destiny on my channel. I mean, Rise of Iron isn't necessarily part of the Crucible, but they did introduce Supremacy, a new mode that is quite addicting, and it's fun to play, but here comes the problem. It still ends up, you still get drowned out on it. It still ends up being repetitive, and that's just not the type or the way that it feels like Destiny should be. With as expansive as all of the expansions have been, I feel Crucible should have been expanded long before adding one game mode in its third or fourth expansion? Fourth expansion. And their tuning of snipers and some of the other things, and it feeling like certain things just don't add up and make sense, just kind of adds to the whole thing. And I, for one, I'm not really a fan of it. I want Crucible to be fun. I want to be able to just go in there, and before I know it, I've been playing for 3 hours. Not, and do something with their map rotations. In this gameplay, if I end up talking long enough, you can actually see I go to the same map 3 different times out of 4 matches. And that's just not okay. At least not to me. It just seems way too repetitive. And sure, some of the maps are great, and I like playing on them repeatedly, but for the most part, it just gets old, and you get all of the people that try way too much, and with the way Crucible's just kind of turning into it, that you have to have so much patience running a sniper. I still use it because I like them. And the same with certain primaries. I still use them because I like them. Not necessarily because they have the best role. So I do lose a lot of gunfights because I go up against the people that have the ideal roles. Or I make too many little mistakes here and there, but I don't play often enough, so my game isn't as best as it could be. But I still do alright. As you'll see a couple times, or at least in one of the matches, I'm gonna upload some of the gameplay after I get done yammering on. Just let it play. And there are a couple matches that I'm 50 light or more below everybody else, and I still end up getting top score for running a sniper and an auto rifle, because that's the combo I like running on my hunter. I love snipers, and I love my hunter, but I don't play it enough because it just ends up feeling like everything is so repetitive that it ends up getting to me. And I don't like the way it always gets to me because it's not how I feel Crucible should be. I feel it should be very, very, very fun. And where you forget, remember you're in PvP, but you forget that you're playing Crucible modes. Like, how they have their different modes, the Clash, the Control, then there's the Freelance 3v3 that has the Elimination, Trial, or Scrimmage, and other modes like that, Salvage, or the 6v6 one. That has the Clash, Supremacy, Control, Rift. They should have more things like that. That, I think, should happen. Because it adds a dimension to Crucible. Where you don't know what you're going to get. Add a different way of how the maps are chosen. So you don't constantly, over the course of 10 or 12 games, 6 of them being the same map, because that has happened to me, and that just, it ends up, you get tired of that map, particularly. The only time I think you should be that type of thing is with Trials, but even then, it's still kind of one of those things that, does it really work? Me, it can, but I just think Trials should have, or not necessarily Trials, but the Crucible should have a lot more diversity. They should be able to look at some of, not just weapons, not just how gear, how it interacts with each other, how the buff works, but look at the modes themselves. Make some diversity, have some other types of objectives and reason for playing it. So it just doesn't feel like you're doing the same thing over and over again, just constantly. But this is just kind of my view on it. Maybe others will have different views that might actually work, or that they'll listen to. I don't know. But this is just my view of it and how I feel. I'm not a big fan of how it feels now. And something needs to change, and to me, the change has to happen in Destiny 2, Because, yes, they're going to bring back other modes, like Sparrow Racing and different versions of Sparrow Racing, but how far that really goes is yet to be seen. And I'm not sure how well that's going to work out, because it's just one of those seasonal events that it's going to create a little something for however long they run it. But as soon as that ends, we're faced back with the same stagnation in Destiny PvP. And you have the same stagnation in Destiny PvE. Because you can only do so many different things to get the currency for buying stuff. And after that's done for each day, then that's all you got. There's really nothing else. And it just... It gets old after a while. It really does. So, that's why I haven't been covering a lot of Destiny right now. I would love to. And as soon as something that comes that I'm very interested in trying to cover ends up coming out, I will be definitely covering it and bringing it all to you, just so I can have more to do than just the same videos that will end up creating that same stagnation problem in my channel. And I don't want that. I want to be able to grow, cover the multiple different things that I want to cover, and bring them to you folks as much as I possibly can. Because this is what I enjoy. And it's been a long time coming that I've found something that I can really get behind and really enjoy. So this has been it. So I wanted to put my thoughts out there of how Crucible is, and kind of a little bit of how the PvE is, or they need some type of, for bigger events like raids or Nightfall, some type of way for a, not necessarily in event matchmaking, but a social area that can enable a localized voice chat or a localized party chat people can join, just to get your name out or to get more information to other people or from other people, so you can find groups easier. Because right now you have to go completely out of Destiny and hope you can find enough people that play at the same time you do to end up having groups for PvE activities that require the groups. Unless you're actually geared enough to solo. Which I certainly am not, and I've had a real tough time gearing up and getting above the 350 light. So maybe that's just me, but I also feel the way RNG works with loot drops in the Crucible needs to be fine-tuned. Because right now it doesn't work. It doesn't work in any shape or form. And that's not what I want, how I want Crucible to be. I want fun. I want more, be able to have that chance where you're going to get more loot, get more of the things that you want, and have more chances to use different types of weapons and find ones you like. I'm a year one player, and I still haven't looted an LDR or a longbow synthesis or a lot of those ones that they brought up, I don't have any. And it's not from my lack of grinding. It's just with the way RNG and all the different things they have, you have slim chances to get something you actually want. Or constant replicas of the same gun, just different rolls on them. Like the first Iron Banner of Rise of Iron, I got 18 unbent trees versus no more than 3 of any other weapon. 18 unbent trees with pretty much mostly all similar rolls. And that just doesn't feel like that's how it should be. And it was about the same this time. This time I got 10 unbent trees, and I didn't even play every day in Iron Banner. Sure, I got a couple other things that was great, but for the most part, unbent tree was my top weapon again. And that just feels a little much, or that certain things are getting more of a favored stat to drop tables than anything else, and the weapon just doesn't feel as good as the other ones, particularly in the primary department. So you still end up with that same stagnation that I've been talking about. And I'm not a fan of it, so I haven't really been doing a lot of covering of Destiny as of late. I should make some videos, and if something does come out, then I'll have some content to post with it, so I don't have to torture everybody with just recording of me on cam and uploading that. So that could be a thing, but as of now, it just, because you have so many people that are turning, since you can't really use snipers from the flinch. I think it's a good mechanic, but it makes your play a lot, and you have to play a lot different, and you can't play as aggressive, and they're kind of limiting what type of play or play styles you can really play in Destiny PvP, which doesn't add to anything of the stagnation that has been happening in Destiny PvP. Because you get the people that are the diehard PvP fans of Destiny that play it regardless. Even some of them have kind of been tilting off because the PvP is just so stagnant, and people on it are just so toxic. We have to do something. We can't really do anything about that, but we can try to do something where it, in Destiny 2, or even maybe even before that, try some fixes and see if it works towards getting a better PvP experience. I'd like to see Bungie have more of a communication with the communities, and we'll see if that actually becomes a thing or not. But as of now, something needs to change, and Destiny itself is just going, feels like it's going downhill, and going downhill fast. And I'm not a big fan of that direction, because I love the game, and it's giving me, it and the Division are giving me my start, but that's a topic for another day. So right now we're just pretty much discussing the stagnation within Destiny and its content, because it just feels like that where they're at now is the game that should have been released 3 years ago on launch. And by that feeling, because Rise of Iron's story was too short. It just seemed we really weren't going to do it, but we need to do something because Destiny 2 is going to get delayed. So the story was just way too short. It was like, what, 5 or 6 missions, and the story to it was just short comparing to what it was in previous expansions, and not as enjoyable. So it still creates a huge amount of repetitiveness that to get where you want to go in gear or in light or to grind out certain things, that you have so much repetitive of it that you just end up going around in circles, kind of like a chicken with your head cut off, and there's just no end to it. You just go around and around and around, and that's also kind of how PvP feels, particularly in this last Iron Banner, as there's just so many people that you are that just feel like they're there to try to get something different. Or at least that's what it felt like to me. And from that, I'm going to close with that my thoughts on Crucible and how it's just in a decline and stagnant, and it needs some type of change, an overhaul, or something. And once that's done, then maybe we can start getting more Destiny content on my channel. But until then, this is Hatchet Gaming. And as always, thank you for looking at my videos. If you like it, give it a like. If you don't, I'm sure you know what to do. And leave a comment. Maybe we can get this noticed by Bungie and see if we can get anything for changes coming to make it where it feels a lot more fun and a lot more diverse. And I'll leave my Twitch and my Twitter in the description box below. Twitter is the best way to get a hold of me. Twitch, you can catch me streaming almost every single day. And depending on the day, on what I will be streaming. So, I hope everyone has a great day. And thank you for checking out my video.